Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Father, that's the name that's typically given this wonderful story, commonly called the parable of the prodigal son. Now, prodigal, that's not a word that we use very often in everyday languages. So let me remind you a little bit of what it means. Prodigal means spending money or resources freely or recklessly, being wastefully extravagant. But realize, I think that this parable could probably be called the parable of the prodigal father. You see, the father in this great story is extravagant and excessive with his generosity, with his love, and with his acceptance, as much or more so than the son who is wasteful and careless with what he receives. Now, there truly is so much in this story that we could spend days talking about what's going on here. So what I want to do this morning is just take a look at a few key moments in the story and then kind of step out of the way. I think that when we get finished, I'll allow a little more time for silence even so that we can have a few more moments to just bask in this great story. Because this is Jesus at his finest, his storytelling abilities, his core values, what this story says about his relationship with God. So let's take a look at the story. And you may not realize that this story starts off very harshly at first. The younger son goes to his father and he says, "Give me my inheritance now." And so it's really saying to his father constitutes really an unthinkable offense for the culture of the time. What he's saying in his request to his father, he said, "Give my inheritance." What he's really saying is, "I wish that you were dead." Because that's normally when an inheritance was received. That's what the son is really saying. "I wish that you were dead." So, in giving the inheritance to his son at that time, the father dies to his son. And then the younger son leaves as well to life and so forth for reasons that are unnamed in the story that Jesus tells. And in the course of the story, as we find out, the younger one discovers something I think of the paradox of human nature, is that sometimes we have to leave or we have to lose what we cherish most in life so that we can learn to love it more. There are so many graces in this story, so where do you begin? But here's one of my favorites. Jesus talks about the younger son. He says, when he came to me, meaning when he rediscovered his right mind, because there were many circumstances that enabled him to see who he is now and how far he has fallen and who he has become. And what is so moving in the story, what is so very moving, is the way that the son is welcomed back by the father. While he is still far off, the story says, and then Jesus says, "Oh," he runs out to meet him, runs out to greet him. Doesn't wait for him to get to the house. He runs out to greet him. There's no recrimination. There are no "I told you so's." There are no probations to come. There's no quick judgment. There will be no punishment. There's not a speech that says, "Son, you have to change your way. Be back in this family again." That doesn't happen. He doesn't even listen. Doesn't even listen to his son's well-rehearsed confession. There's only an outpouring of love and affection. Most of the time, I think, most of us fail to see how much that we have been given, how much that we already have, and how adored that we already are. The other child, the elder son in the story, the other child has it all. He has it all, and he never noticed. He never noticed. And he was so quickly to be offended. And so the father says to the older son, to this child, "You are always, always with me. And you always have been. All that I have, everything is yours." And in all of this, the father's commitment to both children never wavers in spite of their actions. So that's why I tend to like this story as the parable of the prodigal father. in telling us this story, Jesus is trying to tell us what God is like, of course. Jesus is trying to tell us what God is like, that God is extravagant with his love for us. But God is extravagant, not just with his love, but with forgiveness, with acceptance, with generosity, with blessing, and with honor. Jesus is telling us that every good thing that God is, and every good thing that God has, all that and more, is given to us freely, generously, graciously, and without reservation. No, I think at the heart of this story, it should be called the parable of the prodigal God. In God's name.
Amen.
Thank you.